And of course, top Democratic lawmakers were getting heckled by conservative protesters just moments ago as they walked up to Capitol Hill for the series of historic votes today on health care. And you can see the Tea Partiers off to the sides along with members of the media. This follows that very ugly scene yesterday when racial slurs were shouted at black lawmakers during Saturday's anti-health reform Tea Party protests at the Capitol. And this afternoon, Representative Sheila Jackson Lee of Texas responded to the controversy.
Over the last 2 days, human beings who happen to be members of Congress have been called the N-word, have been spat on, and just recently someone asked me why my braids were so tight.
We should note that organizers of the Tea Party rally and the Republican National Committee chairman strongly condemned the racial epithets.
Joining us now live in Washington is Matt Kibbe. He is the president of Freedom Works. Matt, I want to give you a chance to respond to some of the activities that some of our lawmakers are being subjected to.
Well, first of all, let me say that Freedom Works and myself, we do not tolerate racism. We don't tolerate hate. We do not tolerate violence. And if anybody did that on our stage, we would physically remove them. But I got to tell you, I was there yesterday. I was in that crowd. And what I saw is very contrary to the reports that I'm hearing from the members of Congress. I saw a lot of people that were worried about their country. I saw families. I saw a lot of protest against legislation, which is the best of democracy. I did not see this kind of behavior. And I went online, I read the AP reports, and I went online and watched numerous video accounts of what happened. I don't see it. I see people chanting, kill the bill.
Okay, so what you just saw, that soundbite we played a moment ago of Congresswoman Sheila Jackson Lee, she's not telling the truth, or you just didn't see it?
I don't know. I don't know what's going on. I saw in the videos, and I can't speak for her, I can't speak for Congressman Lewis either, but in the videos I saw, there were no arrests. And second of all, it was an orderly crowd that was chanting, kill the bill.
But Matt, there actually was an arrest yesterday. The Capitol Hill police arrested a member of the Tea Party who spat on one of the members of Congress. And it was only because the member of Congress declined to press charges that this guy was released. So we know there was an arrest. You can suggest that maybe all these people are making this up. But I mean, again, the Capitol Hill police said that they made an arrest.
I think that report is wrong because I saw the Capitol Hill police saying that they made no arrests yesterday. But let's get to the point here. I believe that in any large crowd of people, there may be a racist. It's deplorable. I'm against it. And I think the Tea Party movement is against it as well. It's sort of like blaming the entire Democratic caucus for the behavior of one member who groped a male staffer.
So do you think your organization has done enough to distance yourself from these folks? I mean, they keep showing up at every rally or every protest, and then your organization just says, well, that's not really us and we don't condone it. But they're in your crowd, Mr. Kibbe. They're
in
your crowd.
That's not what I'm saying. I'm saying we don't tolerate it, and I would like to say we work hard to eliminate it, but I haven't seen an opportunity to eliminate it. I don't see racism. I don't see hate. I see people that are worried about their country.
All right. Matt Kibbe is the president of Freedom Works. Matt, thanks for joining us today. We appreciate it. Let's go back to the looking at the what he says will be the financial impact of health care reform. Let's bring back in our panel now, Karen Finney and Lawrence O'Donnell, Pat Buchanan and Bob Franken down in D.C. And Karen, first of all, your reaction to what we heard from Matt Kibbe from Freedom Works. He said he didn't know of any problems with the Tea Partiers.
I was not surprised to hear that from Matt Kibbe, given some of the things they've said in the past. I mean, we've all heard the reports. I would say that John Lewis is the last person any of us would expect to make something like that up. And, you know, look, it was an embarrassing day for them, no question. This is not the way they wanted to go into what they see as, you know, a major battle trying to take down this bill.
And Lawrence O'Donnell, we just got a note in that said that U.S. Capitol Police have just made two more arrests within the past few minutes inside the Capitol, apparently on the third floor. People were yelling, according to one police officer. Obviously, it's a passionate debate, but your reaction both to what Matt said and to how things have played out the last 24 hours?
Well, Matt's problem and Dick Armey's problem is that this is an organized group. They've put this together as a political force. And when you take a political force into the field, you need to control their message. And so if you're going out there in that situation, you've got to be talking to every one of them, checking what their signs say, making sure there's nothing racist planned, making sure this stuff doesn't happen, because you don't want this conversation after the fact. And so the feeling I get listening to Matt is they don't do any of that. They don't police this at all. They make no effort to get in there and comb this out before it happens. And then when it happens, they get to say, which might or might not be true, I didn't hear it.
But don't you think that's actually part of the strategy? Like, let it be this quote-unquote organic force. Let them go out there and do what they're going to do. And kind of like lighting a match and setting it on fire.
You're right. The crowds aren't diverse, and they're not very big.
But you can talk to reporters like Howard Fineman, who've been out there among them, and he finds real people from real places. He found a guy who drove in from Missouri to be at this thing and had real things to say about why he doesn't want this bill to pass. Well, that is the guy who you want to make sure Howard finds, not these other people, you know, and they are letting this crowd get overtaken.